trinkets, everyone. The junk toys of the Don't Starve universe that may not be junk after all. From interesting signs of lore to references galore. We could be here all day simply reviewing our survivors' examinations of these things. However, we're going to keep things more straightforward this time around. We will cover the sources, the uses, the specifics if there are any, and much more, all the while we look to get rich off of it. But more on that later. For now, let us talk sources, specifically grave digging here. We have a 50% chance to roll a trinket of any kind in general, with a 4.17% chance per different trinket overall. In short, there's a pretty darn good chance you're getting a trinket through grave digging, everyone, and darn near every trinket in the game could come from it too. Do mind the sanity loss that will come from digging up graves, however, and there is a 10% chance at a ghost, so I'd watch myself out there. But where is there exactly? Well, our mosaic biomes will always spawn with a graveyard guaranteed within them, so they'd be a great place to start. But our forest biomes ain't half bad either, as plenty of the headstones and unmarked graves will be dotted about among the trees just waiting to be plundered. And finally, albeit not my first choice, the labyrinth offers up some graves as well, and that's all fine and dandy. But there's a problem, folks. Graves are not renewable, so you best hope to get trinket rolls more often than not. But don't worry, tumbleweeds are renewable. Found in the Dragonfly Desert, tumbleweeds offer us a chance at 4 separate trinkets at first, with an additional 6 coming later after we fulfill a specific requirement. But 2 of these 4 trinkets have a 1% chance to drop, the Gourd's Knot and Hearted Rubber Bung, while the other 2 half that to 0.5%, Frazzled Wires and the Gnome. Now, during special events, things change, and other event trinkets can then drop from tumbles too, but we're gonna stick with these for the time being. Good luck. However, don't stray too far from the deserts for the time being, as our next source also comes from one. The Oasis Desert, mind you. Fishing in the lake can lead to tons of trinkets. However, you must remember that the lake only fills in summer, so be prepared there. But we're after what are known as crumbled packages, everyone, and we have a 60% chance at fishing one out of the lake with each catch to boot. And within one can be some special blueprint shore, but these are for another day. We care about melty marbles, gourd knots, rubber bungs, mismatched buttons, potato cups, and beach toys. But what the heck is that? Well, it is a trinket, a very special one at that. Obtained only via crumble packages, we can trade the beach toy to Antlion to not only appease her, more on that here in a second, but also obtain the lazy deserter blueprint without having to murder her deadzo. Good stuff. But yes, that whole Antlion appeasement thing. Practically every trinket in the game can be given to Antlion as many times as you want to not only stave off her enrage mechanics throughout summer, but also be rewarded with things called desert stones. Certain trinkets are better than others, obviously, and you can see that breakdown for yourself here. But about these desert stones, they go along very nicely with that lazy deserter we just got. In short, a deserter can allow for instant teleportation if connected to another deserter somewhere on the map, even in the caves, mind you. Now, you will also need 2 people to accomplish the mechanic. However, these desert stones also activate with a deserter active, and can then be used from within your inventory to also teleport from right where you stand. It's neat stuff. But back to the sources here, cause we ain't quite done yet. The King of the Merms is arguably the best source in the game now, as he has a 14% chance at rewarding desiccated tentacles, gourd's knots, air unfresheners, bent sporks, and gnomes per trade of 1 fish. This is pretty significant, as it not only makes trinkets highly renewable over tumbleweeds even, these trinkets specifically have high trade-in value. But again, more on that later. So have a wort, or just switch to her via a celestial portal to get a king up for yourself quick. But now we enter the bit more obscure territory, everyone. At least for a moment. Yes, catcoons can vomit up trinkets. And while I do not have the specific chances for you here today, I do know that it is still possible nonetheless. So there you go. And we go about rolling this chance by either giving a catcoon fish to eat or a mess of random quote-unquote cat toys to play with, like twigs, feathers, eggs, and more, simply to make them loyal for a time. You can do this over and over and over again, though, as many times as you want. And you see me running back and forth here due to a little cheeky way of speeding up the vomiting process overall, so use it to your advantage. Good luck, and again, I don't know what the chances are. So this could be good, or this could be a complete waste of time. Ah, yes, ocean debris, aka flotsam, aka ocean mud, aka things people have no idea about and probably don't care for, and you know what? I don't blame you. But no, you will not get a chance at two or more at one time like you see here, as flotsam only spawns every 30 to 180 seconds near a saline player. I did this simply for the segment, not having me sitting around for 30 seconds doing literally nothing. But as you can see, a set of 10 specific trinkets have a 1.1% chance at being one of the two items that one gets from debris. So there you go. However, it's not a great option. And unfortunately, it doesn't get much better if I'm honest. At least not out on the water, that is. But sunken chests also have a mere 2% chance at dropping the same set of 10 trinkets from the ocean debris. But both options are honestly hot garbage. They are way too involved, and the chances are way too slim for them to be half worth the trouble. So moving on to a good one. The only other honest-to-goodness specific trinkets in the entire game, folks. The chest trinkets. Because to even have a chance at finding them, we need to finish the marble sculptures using the suspicious marble pieces found throughout the world. Wait till either a full moon or new moon to break them open, and only then can we have a 0.1% chance at obtaining these chest trinkets you see here from tumbleweeds, everyone. Yup, it's a whole bloody thing. And more on these in a minute. Because speaking of clockworks, we can't leave today without discussing the broken clockworks of the ruins proper, folks. These piles of mechanical machines always drop a trinket known as a frazzled wire, with a 55% chance at dropping a second, which is just phenomenal. Plus, they offer a 25% chance at dropping yet another trinket called a melty marble. These are certainly a late-game source, but they're quite possibly one of the best around. So keep that in mind, because they are renewable. But watch out for the not-so-broken clockworks, however. But the last source of the day is more of a gimmicky one, folks. Sploom monkey pods. Hammering these things offer a 1% chance at us obtaining either a male or female gnome trinket specifically. And yep. That's pretty much it. Just mind the poop coming your way if you're gonna do this. Have fun. But let's start wrapping up here with some golden showers, everyone. As alluded to throughout this video, certain trinkets traded to a certain someone leads to us becoming rich with gold. And that someone is the fat man himself, the Pig King, folks. I'll let you guys see for yourself how the breakdown actually works, but note that these chest trinkets that we got earlier lead to additional chest sketches as well. So there you go. However, there are more uses for trinkets, everyone. You just have to know what they are. So thankfully, you've got me. So I'll tell you what they are. A hardened rubber bong and a bent spork can both be used on a sea fishing rod as a bobber and lure specifically. Neat stuff. And finally, Walter himself can use melty marbles within his slingshot to deal 59.5 damage a shot. Now that's fun, but it is obviously not very efficient, all things considered. And one last note here, Halloween trinkets also exist during Hallowed Nights each year, and there are 15 of the suckers to add to the already big collection. They too, though, can be traded for gold, but the Pig King will also give us candy during that time as well. And during the event overall, these trinkets will be scattered randomly throughout our worlds. So be sure to keep a spooky eye out, everyone. But there you have it, folks. A long-awaited and long-winded guide on trinkets within Don't Starve Together. And to think that Don't Starve Together is the easy one when it comes to these things. But I hope that this video helped clarify how to come across these pieces of junk, and also led to you understanding their uses too. Some more specific than others, obviously. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all, and I'll see ya in the next one. Bye-bye.